President Moon Jae-in proposed Tuesday in his New Year's address that the two Koreas make concerted efforts to create the conditions for North Korean leader Kim Jong-un to visit South Korea as agreed.
김정은 위원장의 답방을 위한 여건이 하루빨리 갖춰질 수 있도록 남과 북이 함께 노력해 나가길 바랍니다.
Moon traveled to Pyongyang in September in 2018 and had his second summit with Kim there. Their Pyongyang declaration read, Chairman Kim Jong-un agreed to visit Seoul at an early date at the invitation of President Moon Jae-in. Reminding Kim of his summit promise, Moon was apparently seeking a virtuous cycle of improved inter-Korean ties and better Pyongyang-Washington negotiations.
한반도 평화를 위한 인고의 시간입니다. 그 어느 때보다 평화를 향한 신념과 국민들의 단합된 마음이 절실한 시점입니다. 우리에게 한반도 평화는 선택의 문제가 아니라 어떤 어려움도 이겨내고 반드시 가야 하는 길입니다. 북미 대화의 동력은 계속 이어져야 합니다. 무력의 과시와 위협은 누구에게도 도움이 되지 않습니다. 우리 정부도 북미 대화의 촉진을 위해 할 수 있는 노력을 다할 것입니다.
In that sense, he said, it has become more desperate to explore realistic ways to further promote inter-Korean cooperation, citing concerns about a stalemate in Pyongyang-Washington talks and possible regression in relations between the two Koreas. In his New Year's address, he reaffirmed his administration's commitment to pushing for the resumption of two major inter-Korean projects, the Kaesong Industrial Complex and Mount Kumgang tours, as well as the reconnection of roads and railways. He also stressed the importance of continued sports exchanges between the two Koreas, especially as they are seeking to co-host the 2032 Summer Olympics. He suggested a joint pursuit of inscribing the DMZ, which bisects the peninsula, on UNESCO's World Heritage List like Sinim or traditional Korean wrestling, which was listed in 2018 by both Koreas as UNESCO Intangible Cultural Heritage. The president earlier offered to transform the no-man's land of the DMZ into a United Nations-led international peace zone. He also proposed to start a border region cooperation for the safety of all Koreans. Moon outlined his 2020 plans for diplomacy with the so-called four major regional powers.
올해도 정부는 한미동맹을 더욱 공고히 하는 한편 신남방 정책과 신북방 정책에 더욱 속도를 내어 외교를 다변화해 나가겠습니다. 미국과는 전통적인 동맹관계를 더 높은 수준으로 발전시키고 한반도 평화 프로세스의 완성을 위해 함께 노력해 나갈 것입니다.
He struck an upbeat note on Seoul's relationship with Beijing as well, saying President Xi Jinping and Premier Lee Ko-chang are scheduled to visit South Korea this year. The government will make efforts so that South Korea-China relations can make a leap forward, Moon said. Regarding Japan, which he called the country's closest neighbor, the president presented a vision for evolving bilateral ties in a future-oriented manner. The prerequisite for this is Japan's retraction of its export restrictions against South Korea, Moon said. And he also mentioned Russia by saying,
러시아는 신북방 정책의 핵심 파트너입니다. 양국 수교 30주년이 되는 올해, 신북방 외교의 새로운 전기가 마련될 것으로 기대합니다.
On domestic issues, Moon again placed a focus on enhancing fairness. He unveiled a plan to push for the revision of laws to foster a fair economy and the encouragement of sound management by local conglomerates. He made clear his reserve not to give up key measures to reform the prosecution and other power institutions. The National Assembly has passed a bill on setting up a non-prosecution agency to investigate corruption among high-ranking civil servants, including prosecutors, judges, and senior police officers. Moon also reaffirmed the government's firm determination to stabilize the housing market. We will never be defeated in the war against real estate speculation, he said. This was Sumi Yu from Korea Now.